Stacey Flowers, and today we're talking about the 5 habits that have completely changed my life. I honestly feel like without these habits, I would be a completely different person. So if you are interested in learning the 5 habits that have improved my life for the better, please keep watching. The number one habit that has changed my life is resting intentionally. And I know that that seems counterproductive to the concept of a habit, but literally learning how to rest intentionally has completely shifted my life. Rest is the productivity hack you've been waiting for. Rest is the thing that opens up your creativity. Rest is the thing that grounds you spiritually. Rest is the game-changing secret to doing life well, to creating real happiness. And the specific rest principle that I'm using this year, as opposed to the one that I used last year and a few years before, is the 7x7x7x7, which essentially means that every 7 days I take a day off, every 7 weeks I take a week off, every 7 months I take a month off, and every 7 years, every 7 years I intend to take a year off. So what that means is that on my 40th birthday, that is will be a year of intentional rest. Now, does that mean I'm going to do nothing? No, but it certainly means that I'm going to rest. And rest has been the number one habit that has transformed my life. Number one habit. It's so amazing. The second habit that has transformed my life is writing everything down. And when I say writing everything down, I mean I write everything down. I write the things that are important to me, the things that are important to my son, the things that are important to my friends. I write notes at work. I write everything down. For the most part, I keep everything in my Moleskine journal. A lot of things get transferred into my calendar. You will find post-its literally everywhere, but I write everything down. A lot of women aspire to be really like multitaskers and balanced and on top of things. And I am a firm believer that the only way to be balanced and on top of things is to write everything down. Your brain can only hold so much information. And when you write things down, you have a place to go back and refer to not only the progress that you've made, but any ideas that were true gems that just really need to be developed. So my second habit that has improved my life has been writing every single thing down. The third habit that has drastically transformed my life has been drinking more water. And you guys see me drink water in nearly all of my videos. It's something very early on, I think I've probably been drinking water like excessively or obsessively for at least 16 or 17 years. And all while I was raising my son, I totally convinced him that like water is the secret elixir for everything. So like if he's not feeling well, I'll be like, oh, you need some ice water. If he gets a scratch, I'm like, oh, you know, we need some warm water, we need to rinse it underwater. So I just like change the temperature of water depending on whatever symptom or ailment he expresses that he's experiencing. And I've done that intentionally because I want him to believe in the idea that he's a healthy human being, but more so I just want him to gravitate towards a drink that is actually going to be beneficial to the body. Water is very restorative. It's very replenishing. So much of our body is water. So much of our brain is water. And so many of us are running around with less energy, less enthusiasm, less health, less vitality for life because we're thirsty. And we think that if we're thirsty, we should grab a sugary substance, but in reality that is not quenching our thirst. It may be delighting our taste buds, but it's not quenching our thirst. And so my favorite water of all time, if you're wondering, is Smart Water. I love it because it's like drinking an affirmation, but water has changed my life. The fourth habit that has completely transformed my life has been shifting from the space of setting goals to setting intentions. And I mentioned this before in a couple of my videos, but a goal is very much your target. So if you are imagining a bull's eye and you're thinking, this is the target that I'm trying to hit, I'm trying to get in the center. What an intention is the work that you do when you're trying to aim at that target. And so what I found in my goal setting and my goal achieving experiences is that I have always been very clear on my target. I've always been very clear about what I wanted, but my clarity of what I wanted wasn't serving me in getting what I wanted. And so I needed to figure out another way to get there. And so I tried a bunch of different things, and it wasn't until I really started to do research on intentions that I was just like, oh, intentions are the energy that you're putting behind the momentum that's propelling you towards the target. And I was like, that really feels like aim to me. Like if I was shooting a bow and arrow, it would be whether or not like my bow is pointed up or my bow is pointed towards the center, to the left, to the right. Like that's really what determines whether or not I hit the target. And what I found is that getting more focused on intentions as opposed to being so focused on my target allowed me to hit my goal, aka my target, nearly every single time. And much faster. And the fifth and final habit that has completely transformed my life has been doing a monthly budget. And I've been doing a monthly budget for a very long time. I've been doing it for 6 months now here publicly on YouTube, but I've been doing a monthly budget for years, and it changes everything. As much as we would love to believe that our brain has the ability to hold our paychecks, our spouse's paychecks, our kids' commission and allowance, all of our bills, so as much as we want to believe that our brain has the ability to hold all of that information, calculate it on a dime, make sure that we're not going over, as much as we want to believe in the capacity of our brain to be able to do that and to be able to adjust for the different things that happen each month, our brain is not equipped, nor is it built to do that. And doing a monthly budget, not only does it give your brain a break, but it gives you a psychological boost in that you literally, mentally, emotionally, and visually get to see exactly what you are doing with your money month to month. And there is no greater empowering feeling than knowing exactly where your money is going every single month. Not thinking you know, not having a ballpark, but no, being like, nope, I know exactly where my money is going. And if I choose not to spend in that particular budget category, I know exactly what area I took from in order to be able to support this new decision that I've made. Making a monthly budget has been an entire life-changing experience. And I mentioned this before, but like doing a monthly budget, it isn't just about how it's affecting my money. It's also about how it's affecting my relationships, because when you are in relationship with someone, a lot of the relationship issues that we have, whether they're with parents, a spouse, siblings, friends, they're actually financial issues. We don't see them that way, but they're financial issues. Like it shifts. If you have the resources to be able to go and visit a friend, and then your friend isn't able to create this dynamic, super fantastic experience for you, even though you invested all this money to come see her, it's not as painful because you have the resources to be able to go and just be present. You don't necessarily, you're not making an investment that says, well, I'm investing this and I'm expecting this sort of a return. It's like, no, I have enough resources to just invest in being in the present moment. But a lot of our relationship issues, we're not investing in being in the present moment. We're investing with the intention of getting something back, whether it's from our spouse, friends, siblings, parents, we're typically investing in order to get something back. And that is not a relationship issue. That is a money issue. And doing a monthly budget has helped me to clear up a lot of those money issues that are masquerading as relationship issues. So those are the five habits that have completely transformed my life. They make life better. They make life fuller. They enable me to create authentic happiness. And for me, that is what we are all running around on this planet doing. We are attempting to create real happiness for ourselves. And I am a firm believer that your habits are the thing that enable you to create authentic, real happiness. So I am so grateful for you all supporting my work. I appreciate every single one of your views and each and every single one of your comments. Until next time, I will talk to you very soon. Bye.